Okay, so this is an important step to note. So after field inspection, it goes for the NOC verification process. So what happens in NOC verification process is that, so when we created the application, we saw that one application got forked into three applications, one for department, one for fire NOC, one for Airport Authority of India user. So now what happens is, so my primary job as a NOC verifier is to verify whether or no existing certificates are approved for this particular application. Now as a user, I'm seeing the inspection report. I'm seeing the application detail. So now I am seeing that the NOCs are not processed further. So both Fire and Airport Authority of India are not processed. See, the NOC integration can happen in a three modes actually. One is direct API to API interface call. So that is system just talk to system and then gets an output. Other thing is that we provide either there is a we provide a login to the system. We provide a login to the NOC user to log into the digit system, process the application, and then so that login for the NOC user is just an interface there. He can see the application, he can download the artifacts from the application, he can process the application manually in his department. Once the process ends manually, there is an output that got generated manually, right? Whether it is approved or rejected. So you can take that output, again come back to the digit login, and then say for this particular application reference, we process it manually. The output is success, and this is a success output. You can attach the success output and say submit. So what happens is, if it is success, you can say success. If it is failure, you can say failure. If he updates in such a manner, Digit can understand that this application was processed by the Fire NOC user manually, but he has uploaded that information into the Digit system using the credentials given for the Fire NOC user. So if that happens, this Fire NOC application reference, what you are seeing at 24, will be updated. It would say a few more columns added here saying that this application is approved and this is the document that is uploaded by the Fire NOC user. This is one other way of doing it. Other way is, which is totally manual. Assume that the NOC verification user of the department is completely responsible. He will manually write it to the Fire NOC or Airport Authority of India department saying that there is an application with such diagram in your airport zone, whether you are giving NOC or not. And then manually the user talks to the airport department, gets it verified, gets the NOC, and postally gets the output. And then that output is scanned and uploaded here by the NOC verification user of the department. So these are all the three modes in which we can work. The first API to API interface, we didn't get a chance, or we didn't find a party to do that. So still, but we have the API capability to get integrated with any third party NOC department, but it is not implemented yet. But the case two is done and the case three is also done. So that's what we are going to see now. So as you can see, both the application status are like, it is just submitted and it is in progress. It is either not rejected or approved. So what I will do is I'll showcase the second use case, what I told you. A Fire NOC user can log into digit system, process his application, and then see whether it is approved or rejected. We'll see that use case first, second use case. So now the pointer, I'm logging out from the ULB employee login. I'm logging in as a Fire NOC department user with the credentials given to me. As you can see, 24 is a application reference number which you created. So you can see the source module is building plan approval and application reference is 24. As a FireEnergy user, I can see the source module so that I can see the diagram, I can see the scrutiny report output, which is important for a FireEnergy user to understand what is a building, how it is constructed, and how many floors are there. So if you can see that info, you can see the inspection report as well. You can see all the details. So this is a diagram. Based on this information, you can process the application in this department. And finally, once the process ends, you can come back again to the login. You can say either it is accepted, approved or rejected, and upload a acceptance certificate. So assume that there's an acceptance certificate generated by a FireEnergy user. If it is rejected, I can simply say it is rejected. So now you can see this status update got reflected in the NOC verifier login of the department under the FireEnergy card, which we are seeing sometime ago. We'll be doing all these things tomorrow. Please follow. So now, earlier this space was completely empty, as you would have noticed. It contained only two columns earlier. Now, there you can see the third column got added. There is an approval reference number. There is an approval or rejected date on. And the file which got uploaded is here. So if I need to view the file, I can view the file. So this is the second use case. And the third use case is, I told you, right? So which is completely manual, and postally by post, the NOC user is giving the airport authority of India NOC. You can scan the document and upload it here. So he is the complete owner of it. You can upload the document. So upload it. Now we can see all the info NOCs are verified, and we can forward it to the next level officer for approval. Right. And we are in the last step.